Welcome to the Stoa. The Stoa is a digital campfire where we cohere and dialogue about what matters most at the knife's edge of what's happening now. All right, everyone. Welcome to the Stoa. I'm Peter Lindbergh, and some of you may know I run the Stoic group here in Toronto, Canada. And obviously, we can't meet in person right now, so I decided to launch the Stoa. And I'm seeing the Stoa as not necessarily a place to always talk about Stoicism, but as a digital campfire to cohere and dialogue and practice about what matters most at the knife's edge of this moment. We have a lot of cool practices and talks coming up, which you can see at www.thestoa.ca. And I'll include that in the chat and make an announcement at the end. But today we have Steve Beattie from Breathing in Nature. Steve is a trained Wim Hof. He's trained in the Wim Hof method by Wim Hof himself, I believe. And his personal practice includes, breath work, and it has like a Stoic spin to it. So I'll let Steve explain that himself. So Steve, I'll hand it over to you.
There we go. Can everybody hear me? Yes, excellent. Well, good morning, everyone. It's a strange way to meet. I hold a lot of workshops and breath classes and do a lot of public speaking. And normally I'm shaking hands and hugging people and high-fiving, and it's not happening these days. It's a brave new world we're in. So thank you for taking time out of your day to participate. So as Peter said, I'm a breathwork instructor. I'm a certified level 2 instructor with the Wim Hof method. But I do a lot of different stuff around that. But my personal coaching practice that I have is teaching people how to become in touch with themselves and to observe their own state during any given moment. And right now seems to be a perfect time to practice observing your state of mind. It's near impossible not to be in a panic all the time right now. You turn on the news, you turn on social media, you listen to somebody walking down the sidewalk if you go outside. And it's panic all the time. But that panicking doesn't get us anywhere. We all know that. It's really a secondary emotion. We have primary emotions and secondary emotions. The primary emotion is that initial thing that happens. You get some great news, and it's, you're super happy, you're thrilled. You have some bad news, you're angry, but then it passes. And then we fill in the blanks with secondary emotions. And that's where stress and anxiety and fear starts to dwell and sit heavy in our hearts and our minds. And we just sit and we worry and we're frightened. These are all secondary emotions, and it's things that we can't do anything about. And Stoicism, as we know, that it's about observing what this current moment is, and can I do something about this? How am I experiencing this? Can I change it? But we get trapped in that all the time. And I'm sure we've all had a really bad day. We've been wound up, and we've been upset, and somebody tells you to calm down, which is impossible to do. You can't calm down. Once your brain is spinning, and you're going out of control, and your brain is on fire, you're stressed out, you're anxious, you're fearful, just saying, oh, well, don't be. That doesn't work. That's not how it works. We actually have to hack into our brain and alter the state that we're experiencing. And we can do that with breath work. And that's what surprised me. I got into the Wim Hof method years ago now, over 6 years ago. I started my journey down the Wim Hof method. I became an instructor almost 3 years ago now. But I got into it because of a physical ailment, and the Wim Hof method uses breath work and cold exposure and reduces inflammation in the body, and I was having an inflammatory problem. So I took up the Wim Hof method. But in so doing, I discovered something else about me. My mind changed when I got into this breath work and this cold exposure and this meditation. And I realized the cold exposure and the breath work were just hacks to get into the brain. And I realized that I wasn't suffering from any kind of mental illness or anything like that. I realized I was suffering from or lack of mental wellness is what I had. I was always a little uneasy, always a little stressed out, always a little anxious. And looking back now, I realized I had all sorts of anxiety problems growing up when I was in high school. I lived with it. I just thought that was a normal way to be until it went away. And so I started going deeper in this breath work and digging deeper into myself and into my subconscious and into my emotional state, and did an awful lot of work. And so now I take people through that same journey through breath work, and there'll be a link somewhere along the line. I have a coaching program called Becoming the Observer, which is a day-long deep dive into breath work and meditation and cold exposure and movement and all sorts of stuff. But through breath work, what happens when we just simply observe your breath? And by that, I mean just paying attention to it, feeling the air moving in and out of your nose, or feeling the rise and fall of your belly or chest. Or people who are experienced in a focus meditation, we like to pick a point kind of just beyond your nose and focus on that point as you breathe. It's very active focusing, and paying attention to it begins to activate a part of your brain right up here in the prefrontal cortex. It's this part, your prefrontal cortex, that makes us aware of ourselves, which builds our bonds with each other, with our family, with our friends, helps us fit into society and build what we have as humans. But when we're really stressed out, when we're really fearful, a deeper, more primitive part of our brain, the limbic system, takes over. And it's really good at taking over. It's there to keep us alive. It's our stress center. It's our fight or flight response. And we're all stuck in that right now. And the deeper we go into this stress of this pandemic, of being isolated from people, the more we shut off the part of our brain that helps us build bonds with each other. So we're getting stuck in this vicious downward cycle of isolating ourselves. So we're losing our bonds and we're fearful. When we start paying attention to our breath and simply being aware of our breath, we activate this little piece of our brain called the anterior cingulum. And that attaches the prefrontal cortex, this part that makes us human, right behind your eyebrows, back into the limbic system, this deeper, older part of our brain. And it just goes back there and says, hey, emotions, what's going on back there? How you feeling? And we start to notice that, oh, wait a second, I'm all wound up. I'm really upset. That thing I heard on the news yesterday is really upsetting me and I can't do anything about it. And we're stuck. So now we observe our brains. We observe our emotional state by paying attention to our breath, which is fine, but we're still kind of stuck in this stress and this panic. So then we're going to go into a deeper breathing exercise where we're going to exaggerate our breath. We're going to take deep, full breaths in and out. And many of you have heard of Wim Hof and the Wim Hof method, and maybe you've looked at some stuff on the YouTubes where you see people hyperventilating. We are not hyperventilating when we do this. We're going to take deep, full breaths, and we really fill our lungs up all the way to the top. And then we're just going to simply relax. And the air just falls out. Often what you see on the internet, on YouTube and stuff, of people just sucking air in and out, that's actually triggering a stress and anxiety response in the body. That's the wrong thing to do. We want to take big, deep breaths in, all the way into the very top, and then let the air fall out. Now, I'm sighing so you can hear my breath. You don't actually have to make an audible sigh as you breathe out. But if you want to, you can, because we're all on mute. So sigh away, make all the noise you like. That's perfectly fine. We're going to be taking deep, full breaths in and long, slow breaths out. We're going to do it over and over and over and over again. And when we do this, and we have imaging that shows us, I actually did this with my Muse headband on, which is the brain reading equipment that goes around your head. And it shows how your brain changes during breath work. And my prefrontal cortex shut off. It just went down during this breath work. And then when I started to breathe again, it came back online. And I literally rebooted my prefrontal cortex, this part, this executive function part of my brain that was trying to hold on that limbic system was saying, no, we've got this. We're fight or flight the whole time. I went back and looked at those emotions, rebooted my brain, and came back online. And it really does change the way you feel. It changes the way you hear the news. So instead of hearing, panic, instead you hear, here's the situation, and here's what we can do for ourselves. So it's the same, everything is the same around you, but your perception changes, your understanding of it changes by bringing this prefrontal cortex, your executive function part of your brain back online. So that's what we're gonna do this morning. Now, I think an email went around talking about the precautions and the safety, and hopefully I didn't frighten too many people away. When we do breath work, when we take big, full breaths of air in and out, we begin to change our blood chemistry a little bit. We are blowing off carbon dioxide. We're pushing carbon dioxide levels really low in our body. We do this so that we can hold our breath without any air in our lungs. In a minute, I'll explain that bit. But it's that decreasing of carbon dioxide. It's gonna make you feel a little funny. You're gonna get a little tingling in your fingertips. You might feel a little numbness around your nose and mouth. It's normal, it's natural, it's nothing to worry about. Once you've done it a few times, it's actually quite enjoyable. You feel a little floaty, like you're kind of floating in space a little bit. You can even become a little lightheaded. For those of you who have low blood pressure, even if you just stand up too quickly and you feel a little bit wonky, you can feel like that doing breath work. So I would ask everybody to make sure you are in a very safe place. You're sitting comfortably in an armchair. You're lying on the couch. You're lying on a mat on the floor. You're lying in bed. Something like that, that if you do become a little lightheaded and you start to get a little wobbly, you're already on the ground. Now, when this happens, you don't just black out and hit the ground. You get a little lightheaded and you go, I gotta lie down. So there's nothing much to worry about there, but it is something to be aware of. So safety first. Our contraindications to breath work and the Wim Hof method is if you have uncontrolled epilepsy. So you have epilepsy and medications don't help with that. Breath work is not for you. Exaggerating your breath and superventilating can trigger epileptic events. Also pregnancy. We haven't tested it on pregnant women. I know three now who are also Wim Hof Method instructors who became pregnant and continue to do their breath work and their cold exposure and they're fine. But don't change the things that you're doing if you're pregnant. So if you are pregnant, just enjoy the breath work. Be aware of your breath and breathe deep, full breaths, but don't push it. And that goes for everybody, whether you're pregnant or not. Don't push it. Listen to your body and enjoy it. So you're going to be taking these deep, full breaths of air in and out as deep as you can, and you'll let it go over and over and over again. I'm going to encourage you to keep going and play some music while we do this. Eventually, you'll take one final big breath in, and you'll let it go. And then you're going to hold your breath right there with no air in your lungs for a long time, longer than you think is possible. And it's in that moment that we reboot and that we begin to observe what we're actually feeling, what we're actually thinking. You just spent 3, 4, 5 minutes focused on your breath, fully aware of your breath, and full control of your breath. And now your breath is gone. And it's just you and your subconscious. And you're just going to observe and see what comes up. And I'll guide you through this and I'll use some words to help you focus on things that you need to focus on. You'll hold your breath, you'll hold your breath, and you'll feel this thing inside you, what I call the air hunger. I'm sure when everybody was a child, you took a deep lungful of air and tried to swim underwater to see how far you could go and your lungs were bursting. You're not gonna feel that. There's nothing in your lungs. You're gonna feel this air hunger someplace else. It might be in your mind, might be in your throat, it might be deep in your belly, your heart. You'll feel this air hunger. This is the stress that's in you. And just observe it, and I'll guide you through that. After holding your breath for a while, I'll tell you to breathe deeply in. You'll fill your lungs right at the top, and you'll hold your breath again at the top of your lungs. and you'll get a real rush of energy through your body. You'll feel your consciousness and your awareness expand beyond yourself. You'll feel really trippy, and your brain is going to release a whole bunch of dopamine into your body. And it's called dope for a reason. You're going to feel really good. And then we're going to do this again and again. We're going to do 3 rounds of breath work. Each one's going to go a little bit deeper into your body and a little bit deeper into your subconscious. And at the end, we'll finish with some nice, comfortable meditation. Okay. Peter, do you want to open it to any questions out there right now before we get started?
Yeah. So if anyone has any kind of questions, Ben, you have your hand, so you can ask it. And anyone else, just write it in the chat box, and I'll read it out.
Can we stand up for this? And if we get like that, just sit down.
No, it is best to be sitting comfortably in an armchair or to be lying down already, because you most likely will get lightheaded, and it is possible to faint. Fainting in itself isn't dangerous. Banging your head on the way down is dangerous. So if you're already on the floor, you're going to be fine. And saying that, if you're doing this and you're feeling like really wonky and you realize that breathing isn't your thing, you don't like breathing, hopefully you like breathing. If you don't like doing deep breath work, just go back to your regular breath, right? Listen to your body. Don't push your way through because you're supposed to do this. You're not supposed to do anything. You're supposed to listen to your body and pay attention. So if you're feeling a little funny, go back to your regular breath. Be comfortable. Lie on the couch. Lie on the floor. Lie on your bed, or sit comfortably in a big armchair, whatever works for you. Mm-hmm.
So if anyone has any other questions, just put question or cue in the chat box, and then I'll call on you and you can go off mute. And so one question for you, Steve, if someone maybe feels uncomfortable right now and they just want to watch, this is going to be on video recorded on YouTube, so they can always practice this afterwards when they feel more comfortable.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a lot of the time that's, When people first do a breath practice, there's part of them is just holding back a little bit, wondering, you know, what's going to happen next.
Yes.
So it's hard to completely surrender to the process of breath work and the changes that are happening in your body. And that's perfectly fine. Some of you might have a Wim Hof method practice already or do breath work, and you're just going to let it go and see what happens. And that's great. I encourage that. But if you want to just, you know, follow along, do the breath work. Saying that, during the breath holds, when we breathe out and hold your breath, if I haven't said breathe in and you really need to breathe in, you're allowed to breathe in. You can breathe whenever you need to breathe. Don't, you know, hold on. You're going blue in the face going, oh God, oh no, this is terrible. I hate breath work. When it's time for you to breathe, breathe in by all means. If you can hold on a little bit longer, push into the discomfort of that breath hold a little bit, I encourage that. But, you know, listen to your body. See what happens.
Cool. So it looks like no one has any additional questions. So I guess we can bring in.
All right. I've got some gentle music playing. Hopefully you can still hear me and the music. Gently, I always like to do breath work with music. I want everybody just to find that comfortable spot. Sitting comfortably in your chair. Sitting back on the floor on a mat, where you can hear me. You have headphones on, and the speakers are on, where you can hear everything. Whatever's comfortable. You can close your eyes if you want. There's nothing to see here, it's just me. Close your eyes and just open yourself to any sounds that are around you. The sound of my voice, the sound of the music playing in the background, sounds in your home. Might be traffic outside, sounds of your building, the furnace, the wind outside. Just allow all these sounds to move through you without judgment. I'm a very visual person. I like to visualize the sounds as vibrations and wave fronts and just visualize them moving through me without resistance. So you can let your eyes go soft, your eyes close, make yourself comfortable. Any adjustments need to make to your body is fine. And bring your awareness to your breath. Find the part of your breath that resonates with you. Maybe the rush of air moving in through your nose and sinuses. Maybe the gentle rise and fall of your belly, gentle expansion of your ribs. Might be that point of focus just beyond your nose. Take a moment to find what resonates with you. You'll notice that your mind likes to rush off to the busy of your day, to the news and the panic in the world right now. That's okay. Acknowledge these thoughts with gratitude. Bring your awareness back to your breath. Your mind is like a pond, and all the thoughts, all the worries and anxieties, the little ripples and splashes on this mind, on this pond. You can't hold them down, you can't push them away. This pond can only settle and become still. As your mind settles, becomes still, become fully aware of your breath. Cool rush of air through your sinuses. Gentle rise and fall of your belly. So you let the sound of my voice and the music, the sounds around you move through you without resistance, without judgment. You allow your breath to hold your awareness for a full cycle. So you breathe gently in, gently out, to a quiet pause between breaths. Bring your awareness into your body, starting at the crown of your head, very top. Let all the tension relax around your scalp, the tension around your eyes and temples, nose, your cheeks, your ears, the muscles deep within your jaw. Shoulders become heavy. Your arms sink down in the floor. Muscles across your chest. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, feel a wave of relaxation roll down your spine, through your ribs, into your belly. Your organs relax. Your belly relax. Don't try to hold in your belly. Feel it fall out away from your body as you breathe in. A deep wave of relaxation as you breathe out. Bring your awareness to anything else in your body. Feel that tension, tightness, those troubled areas you know about, where you hold your stress, neck and shoulders, your low back. Go into those areas, check in. Just let that tension melt. Bring your awareness back to your breath. Now see your breath as a wave of breath that rises from deep within your belly. Rise up through your body, your belly and chest, through your neck and into your head. At the top of each breath, you relax. The breath falls away. You breathe in, you see it as a wave that rolls up through your body, like a wave rushing up on the beach. As you breathe out, the wave rolls back to sea. Feel your breath, it's a wave rising up through your body with every breath in. A wave of relaxation as the breath falls away. We follow this wave of breath as we go into our practice. So begin to breathe deeply in and out. Stay with this wave of breath. Visualize it as a wave of light. You feel it as a wave of energy moving through your body. Fully aware of the movement through your body with every breath. So begin to breathe deeply in, but follow the music. And breathe deeply in. Fill your lungs to the very top as deep as you can. And then let it go. Breathe deeply in and let deeply in and let it go. Deep, full breath, as deep as you can with every breath in and let it go. Fully in you breathe. Let it fall from your body. Deeply in and let it go. Stay with your breath. Feel that wave of energy rising through your body with every breath in. Fully relax as the breath falls away. Deep, full breaths in. Fully surrender as the breath falls away. Deep as you can, deeper than you need. Fully relax as the breath falls away. Stay with your breath, deeply in, and let it go. Open your mind and body to the vibrations, to the music, to my voice. Breathe deeply in with every breath. Deep into belly, heart, and head. Fully let go as the breath falls away. Deeply in. Deep, slow breaths in, long, slow breaths out, relaxing breath, you're calm, you're at peace. I'm going to breathe with the rhythm now, a deep, circular, connected breath. I'm going to breathe together, deeply in and out. In, two, three, four, out, two, three, four, in, two, three, four, out, two, three, four. Breathe in with the rhythm. In, out, in, out. Breathe in with the beats. Circular rhythm of breath. Steady rise and fall. You feel a lightness in your body, tingling in your fingers, numbness around your nose and mouth. You feel a heat or a coolness in your body. You continue to breathe. Full control of your breath. Stay with it. Deeply in and out. See your breath as a wave of light rising through you. Feel the energy rising up your spine with every breath in. Your final breaths, breathing with a steady, connected rhythm. Deeply in and out. In, two, three, out, two, three, 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 in, two, three, out, two, in, out, in, out, two more. Breathe fully in as deep as you can. And now let it go. Let all the breath fall from your body. And hold without air. Your body is still. Your focus, your awareness and control of your breath is gone. Turn your awareness inwards. Open yourself to an insight into your body, to your mind. And go past your desire to breathe. And to feel an air hunger within you. You see it. You hold just a little longer. You observe. You open your mind to the knowledge within. And breathe fully in and hold your breath at the top of your lungs. Hold. And feel a rush of energy move through your body. And let it go. Breathe deeply in. And let it go. You're ready to breathe with the beats, breathe with the rhythm of the music. In, two, three, four, out, two, three, four, 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 in, two, three, four, out, two, three, four. Steady circular rhythm of breath. Gentle rise and fall. Fully in with every breath. Let it go as the breath falls away. Stay with it. Fully aware of your breath. Steady rise and fall. For the rush of air through your nose and sinuses. The rise and fall of your belly and ribs. Let all the thoughts go. Out of your head, as your mind follows your breath, a deep wave of energy rising up through your body with every breath in. Breathe fully in and hold at the top of your lungs. Hold. And let it go. Try to go deeper and faster with your breath. In, two, out, two, in, two, out, two, in, two, out, two, in, two, out, two, In, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. Deeper and faster than you need. Stay with your breath. Deep, full breaths, breathing with the beats. Breathe into every cell of your body. Let your mind go. Fully with your breath. Go deeper and faster. In, out, 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 in, out. Deep, fast breaths. The pulse of energy moving up through your body with every breath in. The wave of relaxation as the breath falls away. Breathe deeply in. Breathe fully out. Push the air from your body, squeezing it all out. Breathe deeply in. And let it go. Final breath. Breathe deeply in. Small hold at the top. And let it go. And hold without air. Your body's fully relaxed. Turn inwards and observe. Go past your desire to breathe. Let your body relax. The stress and anxiety melt away from your body. Become aware of any emotions that are moving through you. Any memories. Surrender this flow of emotions and memories without striving. Open yourself to this experience. Prepare to go deep one more time, deep into your body, deep into your mind. Breathe fully in and hold. Hold at the top of your lungs. Feel the rush of bliss through your body. Hold. And let it go. Breathe deeply in. Let it go. Deeply in. Let it go. Connect with your body. Find your breath. Deeply in with every breath. Find your rhythm. Fully in with every breath. Fully relax as the breath falls away. Find your rhythm. Find the tempo. Deeply in with every breath. Stay with it. Open your mind and body to the sounds. Vibration of my voice and the music move through you. As you breathe deeply in and out with every breath. Breathe into every cell. breathe in the air hunger you felt deep in your belly, to your hearts, to your throats. Fully in and out with every breath, charge your body. See your breath as a wave of light pulsing up through your body with every breath. Stay with your breath. In and out you breathe. Find your rhythm. Fast and slow. Rhythm of your life. Stay with your breath. Fully aware. Fully focused on your breath. Full control of your body. Fully present in this moment. Your breath is only now. Feel the rush of air through your body. Rush of energy with every breath. Continue to breathe deeply in and out. Stay with it. Deeply in and out. Continue to breathe. Feel the movement of emotions through your body. The nerve is energy. Stress and anxiety holding on to. Every breath out you release. Release the stress. Release the fear, the anxiety. Release all that no longer serves you. Continue to breathe deeply in and out. Breathe in this energy. Release the stress, anxiety. Release the anger, fear. Full control. Breathe deeply in and out, deeper than you need with every breath. Continue to breathe. The lightness in your body, tingling in your fingers. Numbness around your nose and mouth. You're out of your head. Your mind, follow your breath. Deeply in and out with every breath. Final breaths, you stay with it. Deeply in and out, you continue to breathe. Find your rhythm. Follow your breath. Deeply in and out, continue to breathe. Breathe fully in, as deep as you can. Squeeze the air from your body all the way out. Breathe fully in. Small hold at the top. Your eyes roll up in your head. And let your breath go and hold. Hold your breath without air for as long as you can. For as long as you feel comfortable. You listen to your body. You turn inwards. Become aware of any thoughts and feelings that are moving through you. Become aware of any memories and those triggers. Thank you. Move past your desire to breathe. Let your body relax through the air hunger. Continue to hold. When it's time for you to breathe, you'll breathe deeply in. Hold your breath at the top of your lungs. Feel the rush of energy, the rush of bliss. Hold. Return to your natural breath. And as you return to your natural breath, become aware of your heart. Feel the rhythm within your chest. Become aware of your pulse. Your throat, in your belly, your hands, your feet. Become aware of your pulse, your heart beating through your body. See your pulse as a pulsing light rippling through your body with every beat of your heart. Feel your breath as a wave of energy rising up your spine with every breath in. This pulse rippling through your body with every beat of your heart. You're fully present in this moment. You're aware of your emotions and your thoughts. Become aware of the thoughts that you return to. The real thoughts. Become aware of the connections in your life, your friends and family. See your life as it is. See your successes, your contacts, your relationships. See what matters. Become aware of this connection you have to others. Relationships. Thank you. become aware of your body again, the contact on the cushion. Become aware of your breath moving through your nose and sinuses. You need to wiggle your fingers and toes. You need to open your eyes. Come back to this present moment, to this time and place in your home. Become aware of your thoughts, how they've changed, how you're present. And after deep breath work and meditation such as this, you've gone on a little bit of a journey into your subconscious, into your emotional states. You received information from deep within your body, parts that we don't normally connect to. And our subconscious doesn't speak to us with that internal dialogue that we are so used to and that has been screaming at us for the past few weeks. Our subconscious speaks to us through a deeper insight of emotions and creativity. So over the next few hours or days and even weeks, you're going to have a shift in the way you think and the way you feel as some of these thoughts, these experiences that you've just had, starts to move into your conscious mind. You'll experience new thoughts and new ideas. So be open to that. Be ready to accept it. There's a period of integration. This moment right now is like waking from a vivid dream. It seemed real until you move and stand up and the experience is gone. So be ready to receive some of this information. I like to keep a journal with me. And after my breath practice, I always turn to my journal and begin writing. And I have what I call the download. I just get this rush of creativity. I just begin writing. And I've realized now that it's my subconscious mind doing the writing in my journal. And my conscious mind reads it. That's when I discover answers to questions I didn't even know I had as things start to bubble up into my conscious mind. And I sort out all sorts of problems with business, with personal issues, with relationship issues, understanding the world around me by going deep within like this. Share your experience with other people as well. It's so important right now while we're all isolated and social distancing. Doesn't mean social isolation, so I hope everybody has people they're talking to on a regular basis. And share your thoughts, your feelings with other people. Let them know some of the things that came up during this breath practice. And it's not so much so that they can hear about your experience, but rather so that you can hear about your experience. You can hear some of the stories, the narratives that have bubbled up through your own mind, some of the fears that you've been holding on to and you weren't aware. So be present over the next while as some of this stuff bubbles out. And hopefully you can return to this recording and do it again. Maybe even let go even more as you do this. I have a daily breath practice and I just go deep every time, especially these days. I'm going very, very deep into my meditation and my breath work and discovering what's going on. Where do I feel? What do I feel? What's going on around me? How do I fit into all this? What can I change? What can I control? And there's not a lot that we can control right now. It's very much a wait and see. But what I can control is the joy and the happiness and the connection with my son, my relationship with my wife, you know, what we're going to have for dinner, all these little things that we can control and how we're going to weather this storm. There's so much that we can be aware of and be present for. I'll turn it over to Peter to open up any questions and comments. I don't know if you want to write or to raise your hand.
Right. So if anyone has a question, either write it in if you want me to read it out or just say question and I will call on you to unmute yourself. And I know Benjamin has a question right now.
I just wanted to know about how this can be done, the other variations of this and how you could find them, just the resources. Is that through the website or are there other ways?
Oh yes, there's lots of ways. So a couple tools that you can do right now, you can go to the Wim Hof method. breathwork.com website. And there is, you can download the app. We also have a free 3-day course, video course. So you get an email every day and you can follow along. Yeah, so there's that. You can also go to, I do a streaming event tonight, actually, at 7 p.m. tonight, but also Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday morning. I stream live with music and lights and the whole bit. And I do that through mindsetbraingym.com on www.mindsetbraingym.com. And so right now you can sign up for a 7-day trial. It's a free trial. And then you can see all the meditation that we have that we stream there. That's the meditation gym in Toronto. So it's free for 7 days. And then that turns into a membership-based thing. And I have some content coming out. I'm going to be doing a lot more of these streaming events, either through, turn the music back on here. There we go. Either through this format on Zoom, or I'm going to be doing some YouTube videos are coming out in the next little while. So you can follow along on all my socials, which is, again, Breathing in Nature. So there's going to be lots and lots of different things coming out. That's actually one of the upsides to this thing that we're all going through right now, all this streaming media and doing some recordings and events. Were it's always something I wanted to do, but why bother? but now I've got the little bit more of a fire under me to get going, and I have a professionally produced recording coming out in the next few months that is going to be launched on Bandcamp. It's going to be a paid thing. I don't know what the price is. It's going to be $10, something like that. That you'll be able to download. It'll be an hour long recording with I've got some musicians putting together a piece of music that will have the breath work and meditation in that. So if you follow along on the socials, Breathing in Nature, you'll get the alert to that when that comes out. And so that will be coming out sometime in the near future. Hopefully we're not going to be, you know, in quarantine anymore, and we'll be back and socializing for real. But it's always nice to have. For my own breath work, I actually have a recording that I listen to. I don't just do it. When we're doing our own breath work, we always end up trying to count breaths, or we have a stopwatch running. I'm gonna breathe for 3 minutes and I'm going to hold my breath. And you kind of miss the point when that happens. You just need to let it go. When you do more breath work, what happens is you begin to get familiar with the sensations in your body, and you know, after breathing and breathing and breathing, you've got that lightness, that buzzing, that vibration in your body. That's when you let it go and you hold your breath. But that takes practice. So the more you do it, you learn to know how long to breathe and when to let it go. And having music is absolutely key for me. So those are some of the resources, the Mindset Brain Gym and the Wim Hof Method. And then my website, breathinginnature.com too.
Thank you.
All right. I see no more questions. So, and we're at the hour mark. So let's end it here. Thanks, Steve, so much for coming in today and giving back to the Stoic community.
No, I have a question. I have a question.
Oh, there's a question.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. When you do that that meditation, you start with 2, 3, 4. How come you don't use the number 1?
Because I was saying breathe in was 1.
Oh, okay.
In, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
Out, 2, 3, 4. That's why. It was just, this is the way I'm counting.
Okay. I missed the 1. Okay. Sorry. Okay.
Yeah, that's okay. And even when I'm doing that, some of you might have thought that was too fast, that was too slow. That's fine. Find your own rhythm. What's important during that cycle is that we have a continuous breath. So it's a steady rise and fall. It's not a breathe in, hold, out, hold. It's like a circular rhythm of breath moving through your body. That's what's important with that rhythm. So whatever that rhythm is what you're aiming for.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Dwight. If anybody has any other questions, feel free to email me. My email is on my website, breathinginnature.com, or reach out on the socials. And I'm happy to open up a conversation with anybody at any time on breath work. I go down the rabbit hole all the time. So get ready.
One last thing. That you do breathinginnature.com, is this better being done outside or in nature as opposed to inside, in your view?
That's a great question, Dwight. And it depends on what kind of person you are. I do wilderness retreats, and we go way out in the woods without any digital media at all, and we sit in the woods with the wind blowing through the trees, by a river, by a lake, and we do our breath work there with just the rhythm of nature around us. And it is quite a magical experience. When I live in Hyde Park in Toronto, so going to the park, you just really hear traffic driving by. So it's not necessarily the sounds of nature in that case. So in the city, I usually just have music playing. But yeah, I'm all about nature. I was a wilderness guide for many, many years.
Cool. All right. So there's another question, but if anybody has questions, just email me and we'll send it to Steve. We're going to have to close up now. Just a few announcements before we close off. Again, check out Steve's website, breathinginnature.com. And also this is on the chat. This is basically where the video is going to be. We're going to upload it here. And actually on that YouTube channel is Steve doing one of these at the last Stoic Con conference too in September. So you can check that out as well. For tomorrow, or this evening, we have Embodying the Stockdale Paradox Inquiry. That's at 7 p.m. Eastern time. Tomorrow, we got a caremongering meditation. We got like existential dance parties. We got all these cool events coming up. The best way to find out about everything is go to thestoa.ca. It's in the chat. And then you can go to the Substack. I'm going to do email updates. And I view the Stoa as a gift for everyone to freely use. If you're inspired to provide a gift in return, you can go to thestoa.ca and visit the gift economy at the bottom of the page. All right. So thanks again, Steve. And thanks, everyone, for coming today. Greatly appreciated.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye. Thank you.